Swaziland. A land of pristine beauty, where nature lingers to display her many gifts to mankind. Where mountains hide secrets that go back centuries to the beginning of time itself. Here live the Swazi, a people proud of their heritage, who hold tight to their traditions that are to them as sacred as life itself. Here ruled kings whose daily routines were determined by rites and traditions handed down from generation to generation. Even when the British occupied the land for 65 years, ruling it as a protectorate of the British Empire, the Swazi found meaning and comfort in their own traditions. Into this long line of kings was born one whose arrival coincided with the departure of the British and colonialism in 1968. It was the year when Swaziland became a sovereign state, carrying its own flag. King Mswati III, son of King Sobhuza II. A man of destiny, born to rule. He ascended the throne in 1986 at the age of 18. He possessed all the attributes demanded by Swazi tradition to be chosen king above all the others. But as a ruler born to modern times, he faces a world ignorant of the Swazi traditions that he is duty-bound to sustain. And it is with patience that he continues to reign, the only absolute monarch in Africa who rules his country with a firm hand. Today, at the age of 45, it is hard to believe that he has already acquired more than two decades of experience in governance. Those close to His Majesty know the wisdom that is hidden behind the humble demeanor and pleasant smiles. They know the passion with which he scrutinizes government plans and the demands he makes to plant efficiency into the actions of his officers. He travels the world to forge alliances so Swaziland may benefit from foreign direct investment to build its infrastructure and grow its economy. In 1999, he inspired the formulation of Vision 2022 as a roadmap for the nation to move the economy to the next level. He has directed the reorientation of education to move from conventional academic perspectives to adopt a more practical and functional skill-based curriculum by expanding and strengthening the traditional practical subjects. He wants more support to be given to skill development centers so they may admit students who do not have formal high school qualifications. He sees in the next generation the salvation of Swaziland and insists that Swazi youths receive the kind of education that builds their confidence through acquisition of 21st century skills. King Mswati III. He is an extraordinary monarch who lives the legacies he has inherited, sustaining tradition with care and yet raises his eyes to the future so he may bring his people safely into the 21st century. For his perseverance in innovating education that is now changing the landscape of education in Swaziland, the Limkokwing University of Creative Technology confers upon His Majesty King Mswati III the Honorary Doctorate in Human Capital Development.